Firmes de tus pecados, en el nombre del Padre, del Hijo y del Espíritu Santo.
11th century Europe was ruled by the church, which held a firm grip on the hearts and minds of the people. This power enabled Pope Urban II to wage war on the Muslim Caliphate and crusade in what he called a War of the Cross to recapture the land of Jerusalem. It had been under Muslim rule since the year 637, but in 1099, this rule was brought to a bloody and sudden end. In the name of the cross, women were raped and murdered. Children were put to the sword, and it is said that blood ran in the streets knee-high to the horses. Out of this land of bloodshed and terror, a group of men arose. Men that would stop at nothing to get what they wanted, no matter what the cost. 20 years after Jerusalem was taken, the Dome of the Rock was seized by a group of warrior monks calling themselves the Knights of the Temple of Solomon, or more simply, the Knights Templars. In Jerusalem, the Templars began to deviate further and further away from the practices of Christianity. They learnt the secret arts of the Kabbalah, an ancient form of Jewish magic, along with its dark rites and rituals. The Jews had learnt the arts from the pagans of ancient Egypt during the times of enslavement to the Pharaoh and developed them into Babylon at the time of Nebuchadnezzar. In 1307, King Philippe of France arrested them for charges of denial of Christ, homosexuality, and idol worship, as well as magic. In 1314, Pope Clement V declared all Templars as heretics to Christianity, ordering all their properties to be seized. Their leader, Jacques de Molay, was captured and burnt to the stake. The Templars were cornered, and just when it seemed they were finished forever, a glimmer of hope arose from a seemingly certain end. They were to find a safe haven as well as an ally. But not in France. In fact, in a country in a desperate struggle for independence against the English, the country of Scotland.